Right, so here we are, on formation, about to grid up for the third event of the Homelanders Cup, the first race. Starting here in 6th position. We'll be on the outside by the time we get to the starting grid. Running the Grand Prix circuit here in Donington, which means we're going to take a left up here at the chicane. First time I've ever actually done a race on this circuit. I usually most of the time spend my time on the national circuit, because that's the one they use in BTCC, and I like BTCC, and I think it's a better circuit. I think the still hairpin here is a bit pointless, but we're running that today in this 20 lap race. It's coming up to the end of the formation. Somehow get around here in a grid pattern without killing everyone. You know, probably should be more concerned about getting around that in, during the race and not killing everyone, because there probably will be shenanigans as expected. See if we can make my position to start. Though looking at qualifying time, it's looking pretty bleak. Right. Alright, waiting for the green. He's all here. And all hell's broken loose. We're at least 3 wide here. A little bit of punt off to span this. And, well, there you go. And because of the beautiful way that the auto clutch works in this game, because I don't have a clutch, this car doesn't go. So, that's a good start. And there goes the field. No safety car or anything like that, because Chris Cadeau couldn't be arsed doing it again this week. So, this race got a bit interesting. We should have the pace to catch up a few positions, though unfortunately I don't think we're going to get back to 6th. As unbalanced as the field is at the moment. There was a noticeable divide in qualifying. There was the group at the front who were within 6 tenths of a second, and then there's a group behind. They're also within a second of each other. Problem is, the difference between the groups overall was 2 seconds. You know, there's a 2 second gap between me and Magnussen qualifying. Then it was pretty close after me. It looks like we're going to have to work our way back to the cars ahead. And hope for shenanigans. Leader did hold us quite slow on that. With Bob, who was on pole. So he would have been in charge there. He didn't go to the full 100 kilometers that we were allowed to go before the start. And that ended up bunching the field up a lot, which led to conditions which lead to us trying to go 4 wide through that corner or whatever we were trying to do there. No, Potato immediately ahead of us. He's one of the fast guys. He was in the front group. So I don't expect him to stay with us for long. Yeah, he must have gone into trouble. I don't think, I'm not sure he got caught in the start. That must have been something that happened later in the lap. We had the standings on the right. Yeah, and left. And right. It looks like the field did get pretty shaken up with that incident start. Another car. Thought I saw another car there on the right, but I'm just seeing things, it seems. And Potato's already pulled a second on us. Like the guys in front, they are 2 seconds faster than the rest of the field, the first 5 cars. So we got GK Trempel and Magnus, Mr. Bob, they're gonna fly ahead at the front. It's gonna be interesting to have Hyperion up there. Qualified near the back, ended up going through that mess. Let's see what he can hold on to. Everyone on medium tires, there was some talk of perhaps doing on softs, perhaps even taking a pit stop into play here, but it looks like no one's going that option. I'm playing it a bit by ear, seeing what happens. Seeing what sort of tire wear we get in this race, and then I'll decide what to do for a reverse grid race. It's not too bad on my chance soft. I need something to get fast. Yeah, here at Donington. Good track, I quite like it. I'm not crazy fast here. Admittedly, got very little practice in for this race, so I'm practically learning the track during this race, so what my real pace will be seen in the second race. And now that I said that, I'm probably going to crash out of that race. But, you know, that's life. That's what happens when you say things like that. Say, oh, I'm going to have a good day tomorrow. It all goes to shit. You know, that's our way. It's just that. Actually, this has been a high downforce circuit in contrast to our last race at Silverswing, which was definitely a low downforce circuit, so bit of a difference here. Seeing what this car can do when you give it a full aero. It's a bit grippy. Cars with my setup at the moment is a bit more oversteery than I would like. I say that as it gets dead understeer. Oh dear. But trust me, it's oversteering most of the time. You know, gotta be quite careful with it. But that's to be expected from rear-engine Porsche, really. I say these things drive funny, and you just have to adapt to them. Messing around a lot of other stuff. It's really recommended, but come on, I like to have fun in other stuff, so I'm gonna do it. Visibly catching up to the group ahead. Perhaps we can get back to our qualifying position. Perhaps that not everything is lost. I can see Viperion ahead in that green and blue car that I masterfully designed for him. Potato's already cleared him. It didn't take long. Hopefully we can get up to them as well. I think that's the leader going through the chicane in front of us. That's an interesting thing though with this layout of Donington, is that when you're going through the chicane you can see the cars ahead as they go through the final hairpin. Still for the national circuit, BTCC circuit. BTCC usually do pick the better versions of circuits, to be fair. But we're on the Grand Prix circuit for this race. And send best laps, nice. About 2 seconds slower than my actual best, but we'll take it. Full fuel and all that, medium tires. Not expecting to go stupidly fast. Oh, looks like the Maz has dropped off from Viperion ahead. Not what you want. Prefer them to battle a little bit. Make my life easier though. Maybe dragging this out for the race. It's not a bad idea. Basically, that's Viperion in. He's in 7th at the moment. Squid's not far ahead. Flash the yellow flag, someone putting some tires into the dirt, it seems. Maybe we see Squid up ahead. Okay. That's our aim. That brings us back to where we started. Which, boringly, I know, that's where I think we're going to finish. Maz had a terrible chicane there. He said he was struggling earlier in that spot. And you can see why, we gained a ton of time on him. The over-under. He's still got the outside inside though, the next corner. Just such an awkward corner, but we've cleared him. I think he backed out. Sensibly. I would not want to go down the inside in that corner. I barely know where I'm even going there. We don't like it. So tight. Another yellow flag. Lock up. Can go out very wide. So there's one position down. Actually made an overtake. Sure, it came about as it is. It came about because he made a mistake, but you know, we gotta take these. I swear, I'm not doing that deliberately. Yeah. I don't think it's much faster to dip your tire into the dirt there, but maybe it just works because it means you need less effort. I'm probably going to get pinged for that, haven't I? Get told clean up, yeah? Stop dipping your tires into the dirt all the time. You don't want to do it here. You don't want to put your tire behind the curbs into this corner, as that is slower, and I know from experience that is slower. That is very deep on entry there. Too deep. And he's lost a ton of time there. Ooh, Liberian. Speaking of going deep. And there is another one. I think this is up to 7th, I believe. Now we just have to go and catch Squid. Maybe we'll pull our teammate in Spirit with us as well. Technically, if you point to reason, we are on separate teams, but in Spirit, we're all the one team. As you probably guessed from the colours. Good opportunity for a thumbnail. Confuse the fuck out of anyone who comes across this video. They're like, what? Who would actually race in those colours? Bunch of idiots. Love that corner, though. Even though I can't do it properly, such a good corner. This is quite a good track, one of my favourite tracks, UK tracks. Really like it when the BCC comes here, British Touring Car Championship. I need to get to the Donington race sometime. So good. One of the best races I've ever seen was at Donington. Some Ginetta Juniors. Ah. What a race. Touring car race that weekend was good as well. Some say go on about the touring car race that weekend, but I still think that the Ginetta Juniors put on a better race. Ginetta Juniors is such a good series. Like, no one's heard of it, no one cares of it. You know, it's just a single make junior sports car championship. Like, you know, the drivers are like anywhere between 12 and 16, so you know, no one should give a shit about it. But it's so good, and because it follows the British Touring Car Championship, it's on TV when the British Touring Car Championship's on TV. So, no excuse not to watch it, and as I said, it trolls some of the best racing we'll see. You know, generally the best racing of the Touring Car package, which, like, is full of series that are good. Yeah, Formula MSAs are boring, and the Porsche Cups as well are pretty boring. But you know, you got BCC and the Clio Cup and all the Ginetta series. Quality. So entertaining. Yeah, you can argue with the touring cars is fucking gimmick. You know, it's probably one of the most gimmicky series you can find. Yet, it seems to come across as the best racing and the most pure racing, somehow. It's an oddity, British touring cars. It's like the British NASCAR. Oh, it's rules keep it tight, so it isn't really manufacturer battles. Yet there's different brands in it. You know, there's a ton of gimmicks. Like, there's many gimmicks you can throw at that. You know, all the gimmicks you can throw around of, oh, this will save F1, then the purists go, no, this will kill F1, and it probably will. You know, they got reverse grids, they got ballast, they got BOP, they have funky tire rules, points for random stuff, interesting qualifying methods. Yes. It works. You know, the racing doesn't come across as gimmicky or artificial. It's just good, close, competitive racing. And over the course of the season, you don't say, oh, he only did it because of this stupid points rule, or because of ballast, or one gimmick or another. You know, the champions are legitimately the fastest guys, and no one argues, you know, there's not much to argue with. The fastest, the cream still rises to the crop, which is the beautiful thing about the gimmicks of British Touring Cars, is that it works. It doesn't, in the grand scheme of things, harm the competition. Yes, you get the best of both worlds. You get a bunch of race winners. That's someone in the grass. No, it was. Not just 6th place, went back to 6th. But as I say, you, over the course of the season, you know, the fast guys will come out of the top of the championship. And fast guys will always do well, but they won't, but they mightn't win every race to do it. And that's the beauty, it does what you want. You know, fast guys still win the championship, but the races get mixed up, you know, you get surprise podiums and prize winners, you know, especially in reverse grid races, which is the whole point of a reverse grid race, is let someone else win. As we lock up a ton there, and it works. So, TLDR, watch BTCC, it's great. And if you're watching BTCC, you might as well watch Ginetta Juniors as well. If you don't, I'll fight you. Ginetta Juniors is best series. Most entertaining race you can find. If you go anywhere else for entertaining racing, you're wasting your time. Not sure if that was faster through there, it felt a lot smoother. That was a bit excessive over that curb. Probably shouldn't do that. It's one of the good things about being back inside Corsa, since I spent the last 2 weeks mainly driving R-Factor 2 and Automobilista and a bit of Dirt Rally, is getting one back. One thing is getting back used to force feedback, which is a bit different. Surprisingly light in this Porsche car for some reason. You know, it's odd. And getting back used to, you know, the same thing with force feedback is getting back used to rattling all the time and avoiding curves because you don't want to have a mini earthquake in your room. Still don't get it. How all the R-Factor based games, you know, have nailed Logitech wheels with the force feedback, right? They don't rattle and are perfectly smooth. Yes, I think most other things rattle the Logitech wheels to crap. Like, you've probably heard it already in this, in my wheel going to crap. But you never hear it when I record anything else because it just doesn't make noise. It just works better with them. And I don't know why that is. There was a fix several updates ago, probably like a year ago at this point, where it temporarily got better. You know, they saw a fix and it was like, haha, you know, it's not pointlessly rattling anymore. 3 updates later, it's back to the same. So, you know, that was good while it lasted. It's such a weird thing, and it's probably why I've leaned more towards that side of things recently. It's just, I'm just sick of the fucking wheel rattling all the time. Is it, that isn't really prism against set courses force feedback as force feedback. I like it. It's different than the other games I played. But it's not bad. It's not Dirt Rally force feedback, which is pitifully average. It's not horrible, except in some cars in Tarmac, which it is horrible. And nowhere is it brilliant. Back up a bit there. Actually, speaking of old games as well that run well with Logitech wheels for some reason, I even tried Richard Burns Valley a few weeks ago and that ran smooth with Logitech wheel. NASCAR 2003, which we'll be seeing some more of that in the future. Once again, same story. Force feedback smooth. Obviously, with them being old games, force feedback isn't as good. It's good enough. You know, when you think of the age of those games, it's impressive in context of their age, but, you know, time's moved on. They still hold out decently. NASCAR 2003. This has aged surprisingly well. If you haven't seen it or tried it, but you should try it. It's abandoned wear. There's no excuse not to try it. But yeah, it has aged surprisingly well, especially when you mod it. You know, putting some modern mods. Yeah, surprisingly good. Unfortunately, I think I've gone through all the off-topic topics. Because that makes sense. I've gone through them all now. So unless I see a bird or something to distract me, I don't know what I'm going to do. We've more or less holding our squid behind us. The leaders have run away, as I said. They're putting roughly at least 2 seconds a lap on us. Every lap, so that's expected over a 20 lap race for them to just run away, but that was a bit excessive on the track limits there. Getting all the wheels over the line. Expect some shenanigans for that. I probably should clean up. There's no excuse really for pushing like I am. I said we have more or less control of the gap squid. I'll keep an eye on his lap times. And then behind him is the Mads. The line was 7 seconds behind. Means he's a decent bit behind us. So, qualified sixth. And barring me fucking up, which you can never count your chickens before they hatch. You know, a fuck up could happen, you never know. But we should finish sixth. I have no excuse not to finish sixth, really. Though, can't complain too much. Got tangled up in the first corner wreck and still got back to where we started. That's a decent running. There's 5 laps left. Or no, 6 laps left. Adding the extra lap on for the formation lap, which we have to do here to get the rolling starts to work, because who knows? It sort of confuses you with the lap counter. Because it's technically a 21 lap race, even though we're only racing for 20 of them. So it can get confusing at times just to glance up and try to think of, wait, how many laps do I actually have left? So it's really just me overcompensating. Overcompensating? I meant to say overcomplicating. So I compensated for my complication. Why the hell are you still listening to this? Am I really that entertaining? Or do you really have nothing else to do? I know I question that a lot in these videos, and it's not a good idea. Especially when, you know, I've seen the analytics that only about 3 people reach this far into the video. On average. So if you have, thank you. And I think that's entertaining. I know I'm asking for... I'm asking for whatever I get. Look at the time gaps. See if we got any better up front. Possibly Potato, I'm guessing, is going to catch Magnet, who is catching Mr. Bob, so that could get interesting if any of them record their perspectives. And if they do, go watch them. Be good people. Though if you've smashed the 5 dysfunctions videos, you should have no problem watching their perspectives. Turn, there we go. A lot cleaner that time, true. But it's a good thing there's nothing happening in this race, because I wouldn't be able to commentate on it. I can't even commentate on me going to a corner at the moment. I'm not even that tired. I'm living a classic student life, getting up at 1 o'clock in the day and going to sleep at 3, you know? Good things. That's... I probably shouldn't go to sleep at 3 today. I got a 9 a.m. lecture tomorrow. Should probably get up for that. It's quite important, you know? Don't want to fail. Failing not good, especially when UK universities charge 9 grand a year. Christ, got enough debt as it is. And another lock up for good measure. That was pretty slow. Right, these fuck ups in the hairpins and chicane, string in with an echo data. Or letting Squid get back a little bit to us. See what it's like at the line. Yeah, he got a second that lap. Still 4 seconds back. With, that's 4 laps to go, isn't it? So we get the second lap, and we park the bus. We should hold on to this. That's good. I know it's boring, but I prefer not to have to actually have to defend. So I prefer if we just put maybe a decent lap or two here. Put a little bit more time into him, and then that should be it. Meanwhile, up ahead, if the relative is to be believed, we actually have a battle going on there for fourth. Oh, that's a bit deep into there. Slower exit. 7, 28 and 29 is up front. Is it? Front group are a lot faster than us. Don't know why that's happened all of a sudden this week. Speed isn't usually that unbalanced. What's the thing? Yeah, Taylor now within 2 seconds of a magnet. He could get back to fourth, which would be good. Yeah. He obviously got into some trouble on the first lap, like us. So, seeing him get a good recovery drive, it's good. Yeah, fair play. Nice to see. Sucks for Magnus, who's going to lose out because of that, but, you know. Magnus himself isn't doing too bad. Well, if he gets past, he's going to finish where he started, like me. Chiquito has gone into the lead, as expected. Qualified third. He's carrying a bit of ballast this week, as this is the first week where a championship ballast has been applied. Which actually means I'm carrying 5 kilos of ballast. Ooh, look at me here, getting championship ballast. But yeah, that's me, 5 kilos, doing 31s and 32 second laps, and there's GK of 40 kilos doing 28s. So, there's a bit of a difference there. Alright, 2 laps to go with the line. Getting awfully close to that grass there. Such an awkward hairpin. I swear the width of the track changes in the course of that turn. Or I could be making stuff up. Probably am making stuff up. It's all an illusion. Should have done a track walk. Inspected it better. On cue, the fuel light turns on. Actually carrying a bit more fuel than I really need. Or just the right amount. Mustn't have saved enough on the formation lap. Of course, there's a thing that you actually have to play into with the safety car and rolling starts. Is actually saving fuel on formation. And if the safety car comes out, make sure you save fuel there, because that means you can run with less fuel. It's always a good thing. Makes car lighter, makes everything faster. Doesn't make much difference to me, now that I'm like 30 seconds behind the car in front. And what are we now, 5 seconds front of Squid behind. But you know, every little helps. Gotta go faster. Speed, power, all of that. I wonder how the reverse wheel is going to go, actually. Not sure where it starts, the reversing from. Could be from 5th down. Something like that. I think we'll be in contention to get pole, and we'll definitely be reversed. A bit wider. So that could help us next race. No, starting up the front as we saw last time. Maybe not the best idea with the way the grid is currently. Things get a bit feisty again, could get caught up in another wreck, and mightn't get this lucky. Also, just looking at the relative there, looks like the leader. is now behind Squid. A decent bit behind him, but he's already lapped all the way up to 8th place. So, GK's OP as usual. Flying ahead. Looks like Trampello is having a good race as well. That's nice. Especially after the shite first weekend he had. He's really come back into it. So, not much to complain about this race. Overall, everything's going good. Good guys are doing well. We managed to come away from that wreck on the first lap to go from the back of the field to the front. Well, the sixth day where we started. So I'll take that. And that means we're not going to get lapped now that we've crossed the line. Checkered flag should be out pretty soon. Won't even be halfway around the lap. And GK will cross the line. Not so appearing. He's actually going to, if he holds on, he's going to finish 8. That's a good run from him. Especially considering how awkward the timing is for him to race. It's like early Monday morning for him. So to just get up and to have a good run there, it's good to see. Also shows what avoiding the first corner wreck can do for you. Really advantageous, if you didn't know. Not getting wrecked and losing 20 seconds, it's all good, yeah? Really helps. So hopefully we'll do that in the next race. Hopefully there won't be a first corner wreck to avoid, but this is going, Lenders. First corner wrecks are just, they're just a way of life. I just have to deal with it. Come up here for them. Take this horrific final hairpin last time this race. Good cushion behind the Squid, so. Well, good cushion. Yeah. So, yeah, you'll take the finish here. And that's that. Managed to finish 6th. After qualifying 6th. So, I'll take that. See you tomorrow for the second race, where we see where we finish or start with the reverse.